standing brazenly outside the headquarters of the Ukrainian Navy. Inside, a critical meeting on which the Ukrainians' lives may depend. Their former commander tried to persuade them to switch sides, but the new man, appointed yesterday, urged them not to. They decided to stay loyal and proved their loyalty by singing the Ukrainian national anthem. Afterwards, their admiral told me that his commander-in-chief is in Kiev, the acting Ukrainian president, Aleksander Turchinov. But he is worried. His men are hurriedly burning secret documents in the grounds of their headquarters. There are already 4 Russian soldiers in the base. At the Ukrainian military airport outside Sevastopol, Russian trucks were parked across the runway. Russian soldiers were patrolling. The Ukrainian Air Force were confined to the airport buildings. And one by one, Ukraine's army bases are being surrounded. Once more, we have found heavily armed Russian soldiers, but without insignia, guarding a Ukrainian military base, effectively keeping prisoner those soldiers inside who are still loyal to Kiev. Though trapped, the Ukrainians won't open fire for fear of provoking the Russians, but they remain defiant. Across the border, Russia was reminding everyone of the extent of its firepower in the latest military exercises today. But it has denied Ukrainian claims that it's given them an ultimatum to leave their bases by tomorrow morning. Russia controls Crimea now, but no one knows what President Putin plans to do next.